Hi everybody, this is Dr. A. We're going to do some toxicology basics, and so we're going to look first at therapeutic drug monitoring testing guidelines. Why do we need to do TDM? So therapeutic drug monitoring is also often called TDM, and it's only done on certain drugs. So really the majority of the drugs that are on the market, especially like over-the-counter drugs and commonly prescribed drugs, do not require any kind of therapeutic drug monitoring. And therapeutic drug monitoring is the use of drug concentrations to optimize the drug therapy for individual patients, meaning we need to check the levels of these drugs in the blood to make sure that the dosage for that patient is reaching proper therapeutic levels. Also, one of the reasons that these specific drugs are monitored is that there is not a lot of wiggle room, meaning that a patient could easily go from therapeutic to toxic if they take too much, or they could, you know, not take enough and it could be ineffective. So the primary goal of doing therapeutic drug monitoring is to maximize the benefit of a drug to a patient in the shortest possible time with a minimal risk of toxicity. So we want to keep them in the range where it has the right therapeutic effect, has hopefully very little side effects, and it is not into the toxic levels, but it is at least above the efficacy levels. So as a rule, drug concentration measurements should not be performed unless the results will affect future actions or decisions concerning the patient. So you don't do it just because. There has to be a reason for you to do it. In other words, there has to be some benefit in performing that therapeutic drug monitoring for the patient. So the physician must be aware of the conditions under which the drugs should be administered. So again, that could be oral, IV, IM, and all of that, the different routes of administration and timing and all of that, but also how the drug should be monitored and to see if it is helping or harming the patient and how it may affect the patient's body in the long run. And so not even discussed here, there are some medications where the physician might need to do some liver function test here and there to make sure that that medicine is not adversely affecting the liver, or some renal function test to make sure that the drug is not adversely affecting the kidneys. So what are the indications for drug concentration monitoring? So first is therapeutic confirmation. So a drug can be safely given to a patient on a specific regimen, and that will benefit them in the future with few, if any, side effects and no evident toxicity is present. So physician has put a patient on a specific dosage, and they want to make sure that that dosage is indeed getting them into therapeutic levels and has a therapeutic effect. So it's checking to make sure that that dosage is working for that patient. So then there's dosage optimization. So in this one, if you will, it's almost like more like dosage adjustment, right? So a drug has been safely given to a patient on a specific regimen, but there's been just not enough improvements and very few side effects, no evidence of toxicity. So the physician is considering maybe upping the dosage. And so if he ups the dosage, then maybe he can speed up the improvements. But of course, you want to make sure that the dosage is still within the safe amounts. And so the physician could up the dosage and then check the levels again to make sure that these levels are not toxic and that they are indeed therapeutic. Or we could need to confirm suspected toxicity. So a drug is being administered, and then there are signs and symptoms that appear that were not evident before the drug was given, and these signs and symptoms are pointing towards toxicity. So the physician obviously is going to want to see if these signs and symptoms are being caused by the drug, and if that dosage might need to be decreased in order to allow the patient to continue on the therapy. So maybe it's too much. And for some of that, you just have to understand that there is individual variation in the enzymes that detoxify drugs, and the health of the GI tract, the cardiovascular system health, liver health, and just even if within healthy individuals, there's variations, and so it is possible that a standard dosage is too much for a patient and that they need to have their dosage decreased. And then avoidance of inefficacy or avoidance of toxicity. So here, this context is in which a drug is given to a patient that's already taking other medications, and that drug could counteract with another medication, could cause adverse reactions to the patient. Again, when you take into consideration individual variations within detoxification enzymes, it could be that having them in polypharmacy could cause the drug to not clear as fast as in a normal person, or it could clear faster. So again, another way to check to see if this dosage of that particular drug in the context of the other drugs the patient's already on is helping them and is actually achieving therapeutic levels. And so, you know, without interfering too much with the other medications. And then we want to be able to distinguish long compliance with treatment failure. So if the patient is not responding to the drug they're being given, their condition is not improving, and no symptoms have shown up, there's no side effects, there's no toxicity symptoms and all of that, and so the physician is wondering if the patient is actually taking the medication as prescribed. And so the physician here wants to check the patient's drug levels to determine whether or not the patient is compliant with their drug regimen. In this instance, the lab is checking to see if the levels of the drug present in the patient's specimen are consistent with the levels expected for the prescribed dosage of the drug. And so, maybe they are taking it and there's something else that's going on and that's interfering, but at least you can see, have they been taking their medication? That's basically the question you're trying to answer with this reason here for testing. All right, so that wraps up our reasons for testing toxicology, TDM.